being an athlete at WNL, I mean, not many people get to do it, but it really is something special.
I mean, I really think that as far as Division III is concerned, it's the best place to ever possibly play lacrosse.
First off, just to go to this school, I think I'm really blessed. I love WNL. I've had a great 4 years here.
Being a student athlete at Washington Lee is definitely not easy at all. You know, schoolwork takes up all the time that I'm not on the field. You know, every time I get a chance to be on the field or with the lacrosse team, it's the best part of my day.
Academics take up a lot of time and effort and energy and mental capacity. And, you know, I think it's the perfect balance. It's tough, but it's a good challenge, and it's the challenge that you want.
Given the rigor academically here, and the demands athletically, really develops a very strong work ethic.
You kind of get a different side of Washington and Lee than anyone else gets. I think you form relationships with your teammates through, you know, tough practices and, you know, maybe tough losses and also the big wins.
It's been a great experience. It's definitely been frustrating. I mean, last 2 years, season-ending injuries, back-to-back years, that's a tough thing to go through personally. I always had the support of my teammates. I always had Coach McCabe's support. You know, I think that he really believed in me, and that meant a lot to me.
The last 3 years have been tough. We've never made it to the NCAA tournament, and we've got the talent, we've got the depth, we've got the coaches, and we've got the heart.
I think as seniors, you know, we've gone through a lot our past 3 years. We've never been ranked. You know, had very, very few glimpses of that signature win, that quality win.
We have been through it all together, from the toughest losses that really shook our confidence early on when we were a young team and we didn't know what direction our team was going to go in for the next 4 years. From those lows to the highest of highs.
Played out of our minds collectively from top to bottom. D. Mitties, Warren Berenice, you know, Fuss, Connor O'Toole, Colin Frazier. I mean, just everybody collectively, that was, I think, our best game. It's just fun to play in a game like that when everything's clicking, your communication's clicking, people are recovering correctly, the twos are always there, smashing the guy if he gets the ball. Season-defining win, and also a huge win for the program, and really one of the proudest days, I think, for all the seniors and everybody on the team.
There's no question. You come up, you go on the road, you get a chance to come up and play. It's all very in your way. That's a big deal, okay? And I'm very proud of you. I watched this team grow. I watched this team come closer together. I watched the lights go off in my face. And not that you didn't believe it before, but you really started to feel it. You could see it. I saw it in your eyes. You believe that you can win. You believe that you're something special. Because you're paying the price and you're making the sacrifices and you're being good people all the way through. Got a lot of improvement to do. But keep believing. Keep coming to work every day. Keep coming closer together as a family. All right? And we can get that trophy. We can get that trophy. Bring it in. Hell yeah, boys!
Going to Denison, we were really hungry for the win. They had totally embarrassed us last year on our field. Going in this year, we knew we were going to have to play a full 60 minutes against them. And obviously playing them on their field, that added a whole new element. But we were coming fresh off the Salisbury win, and we felt really good about where the team was. Started out going our way, we built up a quick lead, 3-0 I think, and then they fought back pretty quickly and even the score, and it was sort of back and forth. Then I remember going into the fourth quarter, there was a point where we were down a goal and time was running out, and we had to look at ourselves in the mirror and say, well, how are we going to let this game end? Because it was obviously going to have huge implications for making the NCAA tournament and securing that pool C bid. Give up, and we went out there and we fought, and getting those two goals at the end, I mean, I think everyone remembers Garrett Paglia's top corner rip from 15 yards.
goal for the Shoremen by number 14.
The F&M game was, in my opinion, one of the most important games for us. We had a stretch of beating Salisbury, beating Denison, which were great accomplishments. But then we came and lost to WAC, Washington College, and some of the guys' heads were down. Then we got to F&M and we needed that game to, you know, pick the spirits up and really have that proof that we were that good. Grinded down and got the win. It was that kind of win that kind of got our team rolling again and kind of got us believing in our ultimate goal of making it to the NCAA tournament.
Thank you.
think before the game, Coach really challenged us to come out firing, and we did. I think we put four on them really quick. Into half that we had to keep our foot on the gas and keep it going, and they actually mounted a little bit of a comeback, but we were able to just keep the press on and kind of keep digging, and those plays and those goals eventually, those goals eventually fell. I think that Hampton-Sydney was a huge win for us, beating them by a goal for the third consecutive year on their field. It gave us a tremendous amount of momentum going into the tournament.
Going into the Virginia Wesleyan game, you know, we didn't think we really played our best game when we played them in the regular season. We felt, even though we beat them in the regular season, that we really had something to prove.
No transition, okay? Let's make sure we're on the hands and feeders. All right, let's make sure we slide on time, recover on time, play great. All right, our clear base 40, okay? Base 40, let's work hard off the save and break it out. We can push a transition against them. All right, take care of the ball. Play together. Play as one. 60 minutes. All right, do this thing. Do this thing for each other. Let's go, boys. Let's go. Together on three. One, two, three. Yeah, let's go, guys.
We knew that Virginia Wesleyan going into it, based on our past performance and while we got the win, we still thought that there was something in their mind that thought that they could beat us on our home turf. Great, our man up played great, and key performers really stepped up to bat.
Semi-final game against Lynchburg. We knew going into it that it was going to be a fight, just like it was the first time around. So just standing in the ring, going blow for blow with them, one of the best teams in the country, and you know there's a little bit of a rivalry there with ODAX, and we hadn't beaten them since our sophomore year. Play 60 minutes of our lacrosse. You know, if we could do that, we knew that we could come out on top. It was a game of runs. They were making their runs and we needed to make a run. We needed to stand in that ring with them and give them their blow after they had gone up on us.
I'd say 90% of my memories here are gonna be with the lacrosse team. I love everybody on the team, and you know, there's never a dull moment. Everybody's always joking around, but also keeping their eye on the prize, that ultimate goal.
Playing lacrosse at WNL has been amazing. You know, it was rough the first couple of years because we didn't meet our expectations, but we've grown a lot. We've done a lot, and I think it all speaks with our class, my class, coming together and leading this team this year.
yeah, the experience of playing for Walnut Cross has been awesome here. And we've been really successful in our 8 seasons. I got the opportunity to play football here. I knew I wanted to play lacrosse, but the opportunity to play football was a big part of my decision to come here. Both Coach Abel and Coach McCabe were instrumental in that decision.
As to beating Salisbury and Denison and Lynchburg in one goal games, to being ranked nationally in the top 10 or 12 and top 8 now, it has been extremely rewarding this year to finally have all that hard work pay off.
The alumni support and the community and the network and the friendships that you build by playing a sport, and especially lacrosse, is just unbelievable.
You know, I was injured and, you know, I knew I probably wasn't ever going to be the same player again in my college career. I had choices to make on what I wanted to do, and, you know, I think I could have walked away from it and, you know, no one really would have doubted me. I've been going through a lot of back problems, but, you know, that's really when I realized what this team meant to me. You know, I would rather be sitting on the sideline, you know, sitting on the bench with this team, going through everything they're going through, you know, as long as I got the chance to come out and, you know, at least practice with them every day.
To have a chance to play an NCAA tournament game on our home field in front of our fans, and it's just something that's really special and I'm going to remember forever.
I've had the opportunity to be a part of the team for the past 3 years, and it's been awesome. And the biggest thing that I noticed about the lacrosse team is just how big of a family the team is, and there's really that atmosphere.
You know, I'm really proud of our team making it to the NCAA tournament for the first time in 4 years, for the first time since I've been here. And, it's a great way to end my college career. It's a great way for our seniors to end our careers here at WNL. It's been a great experience, something that I'm going to remember for the rest of my life.
What this team has accomplished has been accomplished through hard work, through intensity, through belief in each other. It's a team that has a tremendous amount of mental toughness to go along with their physical toughness.
Certainly at the beginning of the year, the Salisbury game, I think, showed us, you know, really what we were capable of as a defensive unit when we were on the same page.
Looking at this team, attitude reflects leadership. And when you look at this senior class, you know, the leadership that they bring, the attitude of this team, the fact that we're still playing in the NCAA tournament and the confidence that we have and the respect that this team has gained has been huge for us.
I will remember this team as the toughest, grittiest, most determined, you know, team that I've ever had a chance to coach, and from top to bottom. And many times we could have gone away, and we've always, this team has just found a way to dig in and have a true will to win and a sense of togetherness that you look for in great teams. And this has to be remembered as one of the best teams ever here in the history of Washington Elite Lacrosse.
Number 16, Jackson Apollo. Washington Lee goal, number 26, Cameron Beard.